Thank you. Thank you. Daniel, deliver Daniel. Teaches my Lord to deliver Daniel. Claude. We are going to have one last interactive piece for you tonight. Onward, Gladwin. So if you please rise. The words are right over there. Just have a moment of silence so we can give you a moment of silence so we can give you the note from our drum major, Meredith.
My pleasure to serve in that role for the last 18 years. I've worked with a lot of good people, students, community members, and school employees, all who have done a great job of keeping Gladwin Community Schools on track and headed in the right direction. In this brief video, I'd like to talk about our upcoming school bond election and some of the ways it will keep our school district headed in the right direction. The bottom line is that voter approval of the bond proposal will enhance school safety and security, improve parking lots, bus loops, and parent drop-off and pickup loops, improve facilities for the arts and athletics, and constructing a new junior high school that the community can be proud of. Let's look at each of these bond proposal priorities individually. First, we have already done quite a bit to make our schools safe and secure, but there's always more to be done. If voters approve the bond proposal, at the new junior high school, we plan to construct secure entryways, add a video surveillance system, add new interior door locking systems, add an electronic door monitoring system, add security films to all of our exterior windows, provide multiple exits and shelter-in-place locations in case of an emergency, and we are planning separate drop-off and pickup loops at both the high school and junior high school. Parents and students and school buses will no longer mix while driving to and from school or picking up students or dropping them off. Second, regarding educational improvements at the new junior high school, we're going to update classrooms, create flexible learning spaces, and enhance the STEM and CTE classrooms, provide junior high school students with access to high school educational resources where appropriate, and make sure that our junior high school students have the access to facilities specifically designed for their type of learning and their age group. For too long, our junior high school students have had to deal with the hand-me-downs from their older siblings and classmates at the high school. Our new junior high school will take care of that. Our kids will have a space designed specifically for their age and their learning style. Elsewhere, the band and choir will share space acoustically designed for performances. There'll be more storage space for musical instruments, and the auditorium will be available for junior high classes and performance practices. In the area of art, we'll be constructing a new art room at the junior high school. There will be an art processing room, a kiln, and adequate storage. Junior high school kids like to get messy, and the space we're going to provide them for art will allow them to do just that while learning at the same time. In the area of athletics, in many ways, we are victims of our success. Gladwin's commitment to physical education and increased student participation in athletics has strained our current facilities, from weight rooms to areas available for athletic practices. Quite honestly, we're busting at the seams, and that's a good thing. Some of our teams have early morning and late night practices due to insufficient facilities to get them in and out at a reasonable time. To alleviate athletic challenges, we will construct a new gym next to the competition gym that currently exists at the high school. This new gym will include space for multiple practices, a new fitness area, an elevated walking track, and locker rooms. Finally, the bond proposal calls for constructing a new junior high school that will be attached to the high school. The two schools will have their own drop-off and pickup loops and parking areas. The two schools will be joined by a secure corridor that will be monitored by school personnel. It's fair to ask why Gladwin needs a new junior high school. First, the school is old. Some portions of the current junior high were built in 1934. That's 89 years ago, when Franklin D. Roosevelt was the president, eggs were 33 cents a dozen, and gas was 19 cents a gallon. A half gallon of milk was delivered to your door for 22 cents. And some of the plumbing pipes were made of wood, which is the case at our current junior high school. Things are certainly different today. In education, instructional practices have improved, technology is omnipresent, and teachers are more qualified than ever. Given all of this, an assessment by architects, engineers, and a review by community members indicated that it made more financial sense to build new rather than make band-aid renovations to roofs, classrooms, and other critical mechanical and electrical infrastructure systems. A new junior high will better meet the learning needs of today's students, increase staff collaboration, improve security, provide junior high school students with access to high school learning resources where appropriate, reduce traffic congestion and improve the safety of our drop-off and pickup areas, and reduce the amount of late-night practices that our kids attend as things stand now. So, what's the cost of all of this? The bond proposal will require a 2.8 mil tax increase. For the average Gladwin homeowner living in a $100,000 home, the cost will be $11.67 per month, or about 38 cents per day. That's right. For 38 cents per day, we're going to be able to keep our school district headed in the right direction. One of the questions I am most frequently asked when I'm out and about in the community is, how does Gladwin Community Schools' millage rate compare to surrounding districts? Well, as you can see by this slide, Gladwin has the lowest debt mills levied compared to all of the districts around us. That's correct. Gladwin has the lowest millage levied on its taxpayers of all of the schools around us. We've done a great job over the years of providing this community with an outstanding educational system at a very low millage rate. Please make your voice heard. Vote at the polls on May 2nd or by absentee ballot after March 23rd through Election Day. Thank you for listening. With you as a partner, we are headed in the right direction. And of course, if you have any questions regarding the bond proposal, you're always welcome to give me a call at 989-429-0...